Hey guys, welcome back. In today's video, we're gonna paint the face of this guy here. I'm Toby. This channel here is all about showing you how to draw and paint. So, make sure you hit the subscribe button here not to miss any new episode. Yeah, we start with the pre-sketch here. As you can see, directly on the canvas. Took me quite a while, but it's good practice. Time to time to do something like this. It's not a palette for the underpainting, it's an oils, and I pretty much thin down the colors a lot with the oil to get it very transparent, as you can see, to not cover the pre-sketch completely. It's nothing major, as you can see, putting in the colors roughly. And background, nothing major, as I said. Yeah, I started here with the nose, more or less, and I decided to do it in a time-lapse, because it would take too long to just show you everything in detail. These were really hours I put in. And basically just want to show you how I build it up, how I build up this kind of painting here. I basically mix colors that I need for the painting beforehand and put them in side by side. And of course, lots of blending, lots of color variation, lots of different colors that I used for this whole thing. And I think the most difficult thing here is to get the colors mixed according to your reference material and to get them in the way they should be. You basically have to split up the painting into color spaces where you put in the colors from your reference material. And this is a process that takes quite a while. But I'm painting always this way, more or less. Well, not always, but when it comes to painting highly detailed things like this here, I try to do it in layers and getting in roughly and becoming more defined, but I think this is the way to go for me, just to split the painting up in color parts that I apply, check and blend. If you want to see this painting here done in real time, I have this video on my Patreon site as a full-time real-time tutorial. Check it out. So I basically build up the whole thing, more or less. You see me the details painting on the eye. And yes, I know, I had really big problems with the filming the palette that I used, and I had the material somewhere and I tried to put it together, but it just didn't fit, so I promise I will find a way to synchronize this main cam and this second cam to show you the palette in the future, definitely longer. Yeah. See me here putting in the colors, as I said before, side by side. And the pauses that I take are basically pauses that I need to check the photo material that I had for this painting. Compare it to the colors that I put on. And this is pretty much a game of patience. It takes really a long while to get this thing painted on the canvas the way it is on the reference material. And also see that I'm using lots of different colors here. Not just the colors that are pre-mixed, I'm also using in-between tones that I mixed with these colors that I already had. Some lighter tones, some darker tones, some warmer tones, colder tones. And yeah, I think the key to this thing here is to basically listen to your reference material. To really mix the color it should be, and then applying it according to the reference material that you have, and this basically enables you to do a really realistic painting. I am putting on the mouth, the lips, and you see that the color down here is a bit thinner. And basically don't have any sharp edges. Just putting on the colors, and in this case here, pretty thin to get this roughness of the part where the beard is. And you also see that I'm using even greenish tones here, but again, this is, I think, the key to painting realistic human beings and all the other things, that you listen to the reference material that you have and just mix the color according to the material that you have. And it kind of looks a bit weird, you know, a bit too many colors going on, but it pretty much starts to come together. And the lower part here, I thinned down the color even more to get this thing even more kind of a glaze. And I think this is an important aspect when it comes to portrait painting. You need to put in different thickness of the color. The dark color here on the side, and even the reddish tone here, is much thicker than the color on the chin part here. And this helps really to get this impression of realism in. And it pretty much starts to look pretty realistic. This is Timmy correcting small areas by just brushing in some other color on top. And that's a big advantage when it comes to painting with oils. If you would do it with acrylics, this would already have been dry completely. And to get then in these fine variations of color is very, very difficult. And the whole thing took me quite a while, as you can see. It's heavily accelerated, but still quite a bit for time that I took for this whole thing here. And I'm still, as you can see, adjusting the values, going darker on the side, putting in detail of the ear now, and still a bit too broad, and going back. And that's the reason why I would recommend you to use oils when it comes to arm painting really fine and subtle changes between the colors you apply to the canvas. And yes, of course, the painting is not yet finished, really. We have some places where the colors still matte and some very glossy, shiny parts. Therefore, the painting looks not really nice. But I'm gonna varnish it when it's completely dry and then it will look muy bien. If you'd like to see more about how to paint faces, flesh, hands, whatever, human beings, then you might also like to check out this playlist here.